Hi everybody, my name's Megan Anderson and I'm an extension field agronomist for Iowa State University. And today we're standing out in one of these cornfields that was affected by the derecho storm that came through on August 10th. And I thought that I would just maybe walk you through some of the injury or types of injury that we're seeing in corn right now and talk a little bit about what we expect for that for the rest of the season. So right now we're almost 3 weeks out from the storm having happened. So what's interesting is now we can observe a lot of the crop that was sort of moderately injured and is now going further downhill. So probably the first thing that you might notice out in this field is that a lot of these corn leaves are actually shredded. And so this is not super common to run into, but there are pockets in this storm where we did get hail that came down. And of course, anytime we get really high winds, like 80, 90, 100 mile an hour winds, of course, that's going to batter the leaves some. And so in some areas, we did get some hail. And so we expect to see some, or at least a lot of the leaf shredding. And then we always want to be cognizant when we're seeing things like this, that we're keeping a really close eye on our ears. So even these plants that are upright, if they did receive hail, we may see some actual bruising on those ears. And those bruises can actually be entry points for diseases. So we could see things like ear rot show up because of the wounds from the hail. So we want to make sure to be extra cognizant of that and be scouting really well for that up until harvest. So probably the first type of injury that's going to be the easiest for anybody to identify is the corn that was actually cut off below the ear. And so this was something that became really obvious really quickly after the storm came through, that we were seeing parts of fields that were completely brown very quickly after when those plants started to wilt. And so here you can actually see the bottom of this corn plant, where the stalk was essentially severed right at a node. And so this was not terribly common to have happened with this storm, with the outright breakage, but we did see some of it. And of course, those plants, the ears are essentially suspended in time where they were in development. So basically, that corn is going to have very, very small seeds. They're going to be very light, typically, because we basically cut off grain fill. And so most of this corn was in the late R4 or maybe early R5 stage. And so it probably wasn't anything more than maybe 50% grain fill at that point. And so it's probably good for us that this stuff is not going to be something that we're going to pick up with the combine, because it's already broken and laying on the ground and has already started the process of breaking down. But you can see here that this corn it's dented now, but it would be very light grain. The next type of injury that we saw that was really pretty common with this storm was what we would call root lodging. So essentially, the root ball of the corn plant was, you know, either broken or pulled partially out of the ground. And so you can see here that we have a lot of corn plants that are laying at angles much closer to the ground than they should be because of that root lodging. And so if I were to pick up one of these plants, you can actually see the soil move around the plant. So you can kind of see how that that root ball shifted in the soil. And so this type of injury, if we had plenty of moisture, oftentimes with root lodging, what we'll see is the entire root ball is kind of loosened from the soil. And we see that the plant goosenecks right back up. But of course, we were late enough in the growing season that we're not going to see any of that goosenecking because the plant was done growing. The interesting thing that we saw with this storm that I don't typically expect to see with root lodging is that we actually saw a lot more breakage of these roots than I feel like I normally see. And of course, the roots aren't going to be able to really regenerate themselves at this point in the season. So when we look down here and we see how the roots were broken off, it's not unusual to see some of that, but I think there was more of it because we were so dry this year, right? We had very, very little moisture in the soil, In some areas where this storm came through, we were in a D2 or even a D3 drought. And so I think we're seeing that now in that these plants are senescing much faster than we would typically expect to see with a root-lodged crop. So the next type of injury that we saw with this storm that I would say is one of the lesser common types of injury that we saw was actually where the corn plant, the stalk broke above the ear. So we saw it break below the ear, and of course that kills the plant and kind of suspends it where it was at in development. But when we actually break that stalk off above the ear, we lose a lot of really important photosynthetic area because that corn plant relies really heavily on the leaves above the ear in order to produce grain and the yield that we want to see at the end of the season. And so what we see when we open up the top of that canopy and we remove the top of the plant is that the corn doesn't outright die, but of course we are going to take some yield away because now it has to rely very heavily on these leaves at the bottom of the canopy, whatever it happens to have left, in order to produce yield for the end of the season. And so in some of these areas, these plants right here have an awful lot of green tissue below the ear. But in some of the areas, especially where we were drier, what we saw even before the derecho came through is that a lot of those leaves below the ear had already senesced. So if we take off the top of the plant, we do not have very much photosynthetic tissue left to produce yield. So these are definitely going to have a reduced yield. But the good news is that they're standing straight up, and we're going to be able to get them into the combine. So hopefully they're good enough quality that that's where we want them. So the next type of effect that we saw from this storm, it wasn't root lodging, of course, and it wasn't breaking of the stalk, but this is one of two that I would call more of a moderate type injury. And so in this case, what we see is that the stalk actually bent, right? It didn't break and it didn't pinch, and the roots are still solidly in the ground down here, but you can see that this stalk has a really good bend to it. And really this is obviously detrimental to the plant, right? It's stressful for the plant to be bent over like that. And there may be some weakening of this stalk as a result of it. So of course, any of these fields, we're gonna be worried about things like stalk rots, standability, the strength of the ear shank to hold that ear up on the plant at the end of the season. So this is of course gonna have potential to have more issues with stalk rots and standability, but it's really remarkable the way that they leaned because they are still intact, right? They don't have any worse leaf injury than anything else. So really what we're looking at is instead of this being limited by roots being in the ground like a root lodged plant and then being on the ground, we are looking at this plant having the only real issue that it has is that it has a potential of maybe covering up other leaves or having leaves covered up by its neighbors because they're leaning. So other than that, it's essentially totally intact. And so it should yield fairly well, but of course we are gonna see effects of the storm, and it's going to be a big question mark as to whether we can get it in the combine eventually. So hopefully this stands up through the rest of the season and makes it to harvest. So the last type of injury that we saw with this derecho storm that came through in the cornfields was probably one of the most common types that we ran into. And that was actually not where the corn plant broke off completely below the ear and it didn't root lodge or lean over, but what we actually saw was that it pinched. So instead of it breaking off directly at a node, in most cases it pinched and it's basically laying over but still attached to the bottom portion of that plant. And so in some cases they're pinched so far that they are essentially dead now, but most of them are somewhere, you know, they're somewhere between a healthy plant and a dead plant. And so the question is how much of, you know, our water and nutrients that are coming up from that root system that's still intact are actually getting up to the ear, and how easily can that stuff flow through the stem? So what we can see if we look down here is this is one that obviously it's not completely dead yet, because if you look here at the top of the plant, right, we can see that it's still green, right? We still have green leaves nearly 3 weeks out from this storm. So there is some attachment here down on this bottom of the stalk where it's pinched that's allowing water and nutrients to move through that area. But you can see if I pick it up that it is severely affected, right? It's partially broken at least. So these plants are not only going to be really detrimentally affected yield-wise, right? Because their leaves are probably laying on top of other leaves and we're not getting as much ability to collect sunlight and thus yield. But we're also suffering because we're not able to take water up as efficiently from the soil and actually move it up to the ear into the leaves. And so what's interesting is that in some cases the root lodge plants are worse off than this because the roots have been pulled out of the soil or broken off. And in other cases, these are bad enough that those plants are basically already dead. Again, regardless of how well they're doing producing an ear, one of the big question marks with these is whether or not we're actually going to be able to pick them up in the combine when we come through these fields, because you can see where this is broken off, right? The only thing holding this plant up off the soil is other plants. And so as we continue through the rest of the growing season and these plants continue to senesce, if this plant ends up on the ground, this is so weak here in the stalk that it probably is not going to be taken up by the combine. Regardless of the status of our cornfields, we know that there's a lot of variability out in the environment as a result of this derecho. So each field is probably going to be treated a little bit differently from other fields. Harvest is going to be a challenge, so it's important that we take things slow and that we make sure that we're being safe. And we've got a lot of really great resources to help with harvest, to help us consider things like the standability of these crops and the potential for things like ear rots as we look toward harvest season this year. So if you're looking for more information on this, we have a really fantastic storm damage resources page that we can refer you to. But regardless, I hope everybody has a safe harvest season and that we can get through this together.